Well, folks, another day, another prominent political leader, Representative John Conyers, accused of sexual misconduct. Goody. Just what we needed. With all this coming out, it would be easy to let the radical feminists convince us the problem is masculinity. Well, a New York Times opinion piece has already gone there with a doozy titled, "The Unexamined Brutality of the Male Libido." But it's not just this op-ed. There's a bigger New Age social experiment that seeks to not only address dangerous masculinity, but also eliminate the whole notion that men are indeed men. Instead of placing the blame where it belongs, on pervy men, they have to blame manhood in its entirety. Well, I have some final thoughts. There are sick men who do sick things because they think in their pants, not their brains. 1,000% agree. But playing with dolls, wearing makeup, or using gender-neutral pronouns will do nothing, absolutely zero, to correct sick men who do sick things. There is nothing wrong with boys being boys and girls being girls. Sexual harassment doesn't go away by encouraging boys to be more like girls. Turning little boys into little girls, or worse, erasing gender roles altogether, will never be the solution. We fix this problem in three ways. One, we empower women and girls to speak up and nip this BS in the bud. That's not feminism, that's confidence. I was raised in a traditional family with traditional gender roles, and I can tell you this, if you touch me and I don't want to be touched, it'll be the last time you make that mistake. Period. Two, we stop glorifying fatherless homes. The best way to learn how to be a real man, a man who respects women, is from a man. Problem is, the Democrats have ushered in a new family where the government replaces the father. Meanwhile, popular culture tells women their children don't need fathers. Yeah, who needs male leadership, guidance, and love when the almighty government can cut checks, right? Well, guess what? Fathers are important, and admitting that doesn't take a damn thing away from mothers, single mothers included. And three, we cut the entitlement mentality off at its knees. These sick men touch, grope, harass, and rape women not because of their masculinity, but because they think they're entitled to it. They think they deserve it. Well, they're dead wrong. Part of the reason for this entitlement mentality among politicians is taxpayer-funded slush funds designed to get our favorite perverts out of hot water at our expense. We don't fix the problem by eliminating masculinity. We don't end harassment by man-hating or beating the feminist war drum. Masculinity isn't a dirty word. If we continue to blame masculinity, we're just going to be left with a bunch of men who use politically correct pronouns, makeup, and rompers, but still can't keep their hands and their privates to themselves. The New Age experiment doesn't fix the problem, and that's the cold, hard truth, and those are my final thoughts. From LA, God bless, and take care.